Hello YouTube, you're welcome to my YouTube channel. It's Enny Adams again. I'm back with another banger. So as most of you have seen from my posts on Instagram, I'm in the UK, and yes, my last video, the get to know me video, was shot in the UK. I just put Nigeria because I didn't want any comments about that for now. But seemed one or two people guessed based on the setting. So my London experience video, you know, I flew in to London to charge my phone. That's the reason, at least that's what I considered important from that. Well, just to clear the air, definitely we have one or two challenges. Okay, we have many challenges in Nigeria, but like, it's not as bad as many people make it seem. But it's not as good as other advanced countries are, and so all these are expected to be sorted out in the UK on missionary and development purposes. So in case you're asking, yeah, it's kind of the reason I'm here. So first of all, how my London trip went is as follows. Let's get right into the video. Make sure you like, share, and subscribe. Thank you. She did play with my energy. Don't stop. You realize that you're messing with a gangster. Who get away from your karma? Tired of a devil, your drama. If you wanna leave, just leave, no pressure. If you wanna leave, just leave, no pressure. So, I appreciate everyone that said I'm looking better. My skin is shining. Me, I've not yet started seeing it, but I thank you, because how long have I been here? It's just your people's eyes, just your perspective. But thanks, I really appreciate. So, I live in Abuja, or should I say, I used to live in Abuja, and that's where I came into the UK from. Like most people, wake up very early in the morning. Blood of Jesus, like four. You know, three-ish, so you could, you know, catch up your flights. I even thought we got there early. We didn't. We had the crowd there. One more queue. 30 minutes. You people should be fast. The counter is closing. Do you know how many times I heard that? So first off, the day before was the day my work results came out. So I checked my work results around 12 a.m. and I was traveling. I was meant to leave my house by 4 a.m. So just know I didn't even sleep well. That one is trust. I slept 2 to 4 hours that night. So I woke up. And something simple. You travel light. All of you that I think is fashion show, you are going to travel. That's essential. I just traveled simple. You know, jacket that my school gave me. My name branded. I didn't even realize that the entire world was looking at my name. And your names. That's my classmates. My classmates' names. So I went straight to the airport with my dad's brother, elder brother, my brother, and me. My mom has been in the UK for a while. So after that, yeah, so like that morning we just sorted out everything. We had already put our box in the car the night before. Just that was another battle, because the car we were using wasn't, you know, enough for the size of bags we were carrying, but we fitted it inside and squeezed ourselves. You know, four people are inside plus the bags, one car. But we sorted it out. It wasn't that bad. Then on our way to the airport, any other thing that happened in the house, can I remember? Nah. I would tell you, there was nothing emotional about it. I'm on, like, when Niger don't tire person, it's bad, dude. There's nothing like, oh, this house, I'll miss this house. There's nothing like that. I'm surprised as well. When our snaps, I did do, and things like that. So, straight to the airport, five checkpoints. It's not about security in Abuja, it's about some people are bloody thirsty for money. Like, Omo, I don't want to attack any government agency here, but like, there was, you know, those ones on on the black, and those ones, but they cannot come here and meet me. No, the police and the army, didn't really disturb those ones, don't ask for money, but those police guys, they sabi, uncle, daddy, anything for the boys. This one, kilo day, like five on our way to the airport. Stopped us, but of course, you go tell them so you don't get anything now. And you don't get what you don't work for. Checkpoint and all, if someone drives past them, they cannot stop, they cannot chase them. They will even say they don't have fuel in their car. So that's it. We got to the airport not late, 6. Woke up 4, got to the airport 6. Flight was by 8 a.m. British Airways, of course. Then we had a bag problem. I'm sorry, you guys. An advice for everyone traveling. No matter how expensive it is, get a scale. Because as I'm talking to you right now, my dad just went to get my bags from the airport that I had to leave behind. Like, you have to now start sorting out. You don't know the bag you dropped. You have to start sorting out, and before you know it, you've left valuable items. All my shoes. Been here for like 3 days, 2 days ish, and then I'm only with one or two shoes. So you guys, if you are traveling, get a scale. Make sure you weigh it. 23 kg. Don't exceed the limit per bag. Very important. Then sort out, if it exceeds that 23 kg, sort out the ones that are not valuable items. The ones that you can leave behind and someone can bring for you later. Maybe extra clothes and things like that. Very important, because someone like my dad so had to drop his toiletries because he didn't want to pay for that. What? $157,000 per bag. Hey, kilo day. When you have bills to handle in the UK as well. So no, we didn't. We said cargo eats. Someone will bring it for us. It's cheaper, you know. That's something you guys can also consider if you are moving. Cargo, and yeah, it's cheaper than be paying 157,000. What's inside the bag? Eh? Maybe you have toiletries. Sorry, that was my speaker. Maybe you have toiletries inside, and the toiletries, if you gather everything together, maybe that like the same 157,000. You want to be spending 157,000 just to bring it, so you can just buy it again. Yeah. So we didn't think it was worth it to pay 314,000 for that. We decided to drop it. So I gave my dad, returned it back to my other brother, to his elder brother. Someone wanted to help us with it, just say, you know, forget about it, you don't have to pay, but we had returned it by the time the person offered help as well. So we planned for the specific number of bags. You know, it's not like we didn't want to pay, we didn't plan to, but by the time we did not have a scale. So by the time we got to the airport, so was too much. So it was too heavy, you know, you must not exceed 23 kg per bag. So by the time we're now moving into the other bags, that's it, now became extra, and that was the issue. That was just the issue. So I was the one doing all that work. My brother was handling the wrapping, and that was everywhere, of course. Me, I was, you know, sorting out, pushing this into the bag. I didn't even care what moved, and I was just, you know, trying to carry the extra gun on those goods, of course. Those strong ones, no go buy all those ones with the tier. That is the ordinary dormitory load those days with tier. Like, you know, those strong ones, those ones are maybe 3-6,000. I don't know how much it is, damage on your area. We got ours in Ibadan when I visited Ibadan. After my work, I got like maybe 7, I think, or 8, I think. So, you know, the medium size or the large size, medium size. She won't stick to the 23 kg. So we're one of the last to, you know, check in at no counter to get our boarding pass and things like that. Then you know, we got there. Where's your father? Some of them were asking because he was up and down. I was just the one on the queue. We load carts, heavy, But we, of course, we were ready for the stress. We entered, you know, checked in our bag. They even helped me with my hand luggage. I had two hand luggages. They helped me put one inside, you know, the truck, the cargo place. I only had to carry my handbag. So thank you. So we entered straight to where we entered the plane. We didn't even waste time, no sitting down time. But I used all that for the arranging of the bags. No checked in. Then one guy called, he greets me, Adams. Say, who be you? Say, my dad say, ah, is that your primary school teacher or something? I said, no, I don't remember that face. Say, you don't remember me? I would thought things say nah, somebody who I don't know before for long. Not knowing the guy was the guy that was even at the, you know, passport stamps on, just to check my identity, thinking somebody I met for long. But thank you for saying Aisha, thank you for remembering me. I know I'm a fine boy. So you know, Ethro entered the plane straight up, straight to London. Trust me, a lot of Nigerians, they travel, no, we're choke. Even that, you know, that 340 I talked about, 150k, 7k I talked about. One guy was saying, I beg 50k. They don't agree. You know, there's the, they are the nice people there, they are the, those women. Good joy. So yeah, London Heathrow. Because of how much I was doing snaps, just a thing we all do now. Even my dad was telling me to take clips, you know the things to take as far, you know, the tech guru of the house. So I was taking snaps so much that safe. People were telling me to take pictures for them. Like, I took pictures for a few people. You know, bring your phone. Hey, see, snap. Yeah, you're welcome. You're welcome. So, I entered the plane straight to London. 6 hour flights.
Who sent me to be tall? Who sent me? Where did I get it from? Milmo.
Mugbe. So, and that plane, no. I'm even taller than my dad now. Now him stand fast. Ah, God. Enter the plane. Of course, British Airways did well with the food. English breakfast. I want to ask the hostess for Amala. Confirm. Anabula. With goat meat. You don't put things in different plates, too. Anybody that saves you Amala, and we do with different plates, tell them to return it back. It's inside the bowl, on top, with the veggie, with the stew, with the goat meat, with the kommo. Where's my mother? I need Amala this night. I'm coming. No, after the video. Hey, don't shame me back on. My camera don't fall. Sorry. So we entered the plane, English breakfast. That's it, that's the food they served us. Good. It's current juice, surf tea. I don't know who sent me. I did buy at the course. If you are watching this video, know that it was because of you. I took coffee. You were saying coffee. Let me stick to my tea. Took the coffee shot. I know tea was better, I beg. Please, coffee or tea, you guys should tell me in the comment section. Because for me, it's tea anytime. I just the jealous my brother and my popsy will drink tea. With the plenty sugar, oh. So yeah, I had coffee, slept, watched Netflix, eat Jakumo. I watched a Nigerian movie. Let me just watch a Nigerian movie for the last time. Then I watched Avatar, The Ways of Water on the plane. I know that's 2022. I still never watched it. It wasn't that bad. It was good. But the beginning, it was just like Avatar from where? Is it normal Avatar? Oh, no. So that's it. What else happened in the plane? There was this really nice guy. One of the, what they call them, air hosts. Yeah, hostess, host, Abby. So the guy was really, he was smiling a lot. I was blushing. I know they smile normally. That's really nice. That's really hospitable. It's part of their job. They're paying them big money for it. That's why they're in Nigeria safe. So, wonderful experience. 6 hours, use the toilets once. I'm not really into the toilet thing a lot because I don't drink much water. That's something I need to work on. Maybe that's when me, I'll be convinced that my skin is glowing. So maybe I was saying I'll do a 1 liter a day challenge. It's not that much, but something to start from. Maybe I'll get to 10 liters soon. Is it possible? Tell me how much water you drank too, if you feel like, maybe in a DM or something, I don't know. But make sure you guys like, share and subscribe. I hope you enjoyed the video. See my handle somewhere here, Abi. One of these places, you can see where I'm pointing. Yeah, I think it's here. I think it's here. So, yeah, straight to. Then I arrived London, not knowing that it is not cold. It was just the weather wasn't bad, but you know, airport is controlled. Like the heat is controlled. There's warm and everything. I didn't really go outside much. So that's it. Then I did a public interview. Failed. Watch the beginning now. Good afternoon, Bonapre Midi Buenos Tardes e Caso. It's your boy Enny Adams, Waves of WaWa YouTube channel. I'm here with banger content as promised. So today we're going to be doing a public interview asking people to guess the country I'm from and guess my accent. So one of the reasons I'm here is because of fuel cost, NEPA failure in Nigeria and things like that. So I decided to come and charge my phone here, you know, low battery. So I'm here. So luckily for me, one brother Bayo, how did I do it? One brother Bayo gifted me free visa and free tickets. So let me get right into the chance. So I'll quickly charge my phone now. I'll get straight into the interview. Thank you. Wait. You want to watch public interview? Do you think it's easy to do public interview in the airport? Everybody is rushing back, Come on, brother. I beg. I have to catch up flight. No, me, I know they fear talk to anybody. But I'm like, sir, I know his accent. I like my Nigerian accent. What's doing? So I was like, sir, I beg. No, I didn't say I beg. I'm well comported. No, I didn't say sir. They were my mates. Do you mind doing a YouTube video? Public interview. I actually guess my accent. What country am I from? But most of them were trying to rush to a flight, you know, and I didn't feel like meeting the people sitting down because I didn't want to disturb them. So I felt more comfortable with people that were standing. But I promised to do the public interview later. I'm still going to be in the UK by God's grace. I don't know where in the UK, but it's still going to be in the UK. Still going to be my mate. Another problem I had was most people of my age are with their parents. Most people don't travel alone. So for me to find someone alone was a problem, and I didn't want adults. I'm sure you guys don't want 40 something year olds in my video, not at least for that kind of content. So that's it. So that field, pay me because I've been planning for it long. It was meant to be a banger content, but anyhow, it's true pain we fight in the midst of the lack of the video. We'll find the arc to blue. You see that in one of my captions one day. It doesn't relate, Abi. Well, I'll do like an IG post. I'll not caption it. In the midst of luck, I found the app. Woo! I have sense. Stop playing. In the midst of luck, I found the app. It makes sense, Abi. Stop playing. Yes, then what else happened? I just took pictures, video deleted. I thought of like 10 videos, went on Google, social media content creation ideas for airports. Almost nothing come out. No idea came. Only me. Empty. But and that's usually, you know, I should have had a backup plan. I didn't realize. I didn't think about it. I thought like I'll first calm. Everything was just fast. My flight was postponed, dude, like to Aberdeen. My final destination was Aberdeen, actually. But still, the time wasn't enough. I missed my flight. British Airways better people, not like the ones that have A and P in their name in Nigeria, that was flying from Abuja and they delayed my flight by 8 hours and they did not even give me compensation. They gave me £30 compensation for a 2 hour delay. Man, nice one. I bought orange juice, handmade sandwich. After the food I've eaten, I didn't video that one. It's for only me to see, but it was beautiful. I enjoyed it. So, yes, by the way, my brother was my cameraman. Doing very well. He's ways of our team, AET management. Stop playing. So, that's it. My dad was even saying I should do an interview for him, but no time for that. We didn't have much time. But thank God it was a connection flight, so we didn't have to be carrying that, but that same stress we had in Nigeria, in London. So, well-organized country, the UK. So, we entered the plane in groups to Aberdeen, and we checked in, we boarded, got our passport stamped. That's, you know, asked a few questions, smiled. Very nice people, you know, the border force, Abi, that's what they call them. A few queues, but according to civic education in secondary school, queue is a mode for orderliness. So, Aberdeen flights were the only blacks. I didn't care that much. It was rainy. Had a few turns, like the plane, but we arrived successfully. That's the only one that I see Nigeria better pass. What they call this thing again? It starts with T, is in calls. Trots, no. Ire. So headphone has covered this year. So it's like, you know that thing in calls now? It's not biscuits. It starts with TR, I think. That's all they give us, and water. The water safe now, spring water. Please, if you know what spring water means, I am officially embarrassing myself and saying I don't know. Please, is this special water? Because now water, don't get special tastes. Or is it a name? I don't know. But the food was beautiful, the experience was beautiful. Definitely, I recommend it. Find a way to the UK if that's what the Lord has told you to do. I'm here for education, I'm here for ministry, I'm here for content creation, and I'm here for success. And I'm sure you all will be part of it. I wish me luck. I hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure you like, share, and subscribe. Bye, and expect another video next week. Should be my birthday vlog. I don't know. Let's see. Bye, guys.
I enter from Abuja, go kwakwa lata. Only more taka surface, ya wata. I know fit for some, if it don't pass my power. I roll up a shawarma, I get for kwakwa lata.
The socket is the boss. Yeah? I am the boss. I choose when to use you. So I'm not using you now. Yay! So I finally succeeded in charging my phone, guys. That's the important thing. And now my battery chooses to be whatever it is at any time. It could be 100 now, and I can allow it to be 1. But I know there's always light. And yes, I always had light in Abuja, or like, not always, but most times. Just that I was speaking on behalf of the masses.